Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And during a recent live stream, someone asked, hey, if I delete a table or a file from my lake house, can I restore it? And to be honest, initially, Adam and I said, you can't do it. Then Alex Powers came back and he posted a link and he was like, of course you can. You guys need to read more. And so I went and read that doc and I was like, I'm going to do a video on this. And before I could do the video, Michael Kovalski, who works on the Fabric Cat team at Microsoft, sent me a message on Teams. He was like, hang on, here's a code snippet. I'm adding this to Semantic Link Labs. And if you all recall, I did a video using Semantic Link Labs to rebind my reports to different data sets. And so now I'm back to show you how to recover deleted files or tables in a lake house. So, you know how we like to do? Enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my laptop. Okay, I have this lake house here where I've created a sales table. I've inserted some data and then I ran a select statement and you can see all the data. Let's say I get a little destructive. And I'm gonna say %% SQL. And I'm gonna say drop table sales. I'm gonna drop my table. Give it a few seconds and my table's gone. So I'm gonna click refresh. This is something Adam will probably do. How do I get the table back? Well, if it's within this 7-day window, you can restore it. And there's a doc that talks about this. And this is the doc that Alex shared with us, disaster recovery and data protection for OneLake. And if you scroll down just a little bit, you'll see soft delete for OneLake files. OneLake soft delete prevents accidental file loss by retaining deleted files for 7 days. And then it goes on to talk about Azure Storage Explorer to do this restore. So what I did was I downloaded Azure Storage Explorer and I connected to my lake house. And you can see here's the files, here's the table maintenance, and here's my tables. If I click tables, you'll see there's nothing there. But if I go here and I choose active and soft deletes, you'll see that I have a couple of tables that I deleted. And this is the particular one that I want to get restored. There's probably ways I can use Azure Storage Explorer to download it and do things like that. I don't want to do that. I'm not lazy. I'm just efficient. And Michael gave us a simple way to do this with Semantic Link Labs. Let me show you. If we go to Semantic Link Labs, you will see all the code, right? Michael's got tons and tons. He's got a video. He's got tons of documentation out here. But my favorite part about Semantic Link Labs is if you go read the wiki and you go to code samples, he just provides a never-ending list of all the possibilities. And so the first thing you want to do is do the pip install. So I'm going to copy this and I'm going to head over to this notebook and I'm going to insert the code. And so I'm going to run this piece of code. It'll take a few seconds. And this is actually installing the Semantic Links library into my session right here. And then I'm going to go back to Semantic Link Labs and I'm going to do a quick control F and I'm going to choose recover. Recover a lake house object. I'm going to go ahead and copy this. I'm going to head back to my demo notebook and you can see that it's completely installed. I'm going to add a code cell and I need to fill in some blanks. So the first thing I want to do is provide the name of my lake house. Well, that's easy. It's called deleted tables. And then we're going to go here and I need to get the workspace name. I don't know why I made it so long. Copy that workspace name and we're going to go back to my notebook, get that in there. And then you need to change this right here to the name of your table. It is case sensitive. And so you can see he provides even the different options so I can restore a Delta table that doesn't have a schema, one with the schema, some files or folders. I don't care about these three. I can delete them or just comment them out because I may come back and test these out at a later date. And then I'll run this. So once I run this, you'll see that it says, hey, this is restored. And so I'm going to go ahead and refresh right here and you're going to see, boom, there's my table. If I go over to Azure Storage Explorer, you'll see how this is aligned through it. But if I go ahead and click refresh, you'll see there's my table. And if I switch this back to active blobs, there's my table. It's pretty simple. And Michael gave us everything we needed. You definitely want to put this in your toolbox, because if you work with people like I work with, they'll probably delete your stuff because you gave them too much access. All right, what do you think? You got any questions, comments? You want to see more videos about Semantic Link Labs? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric, Power BI, all the workloads in Fabric, there's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Martha, Adam, and this guy, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.